Alhamdulillah, wassalatu wassalamu ala rasulillahi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ala alihi wa ashabihi ajma'in amma ba'd. We begin with the praises that belong to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to send His peace, mercy and blessings upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his family members, upon his companions, and upon all of us, and today especially upon our children. Ameen, Allahumma ameen. Dearest parents and friends, today inshallah is the annual day of the Sunday School of Hikmah School of Knowledge. And alhamdulillah for the parents, it's a moment of pride and happiness that they see their children perform here. And inshallah we're going to have a prize distribution based upon all the results of the entire of the year 2014-2015. So inshallah we're going to start right now. And let's begin with the best kalam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says through His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a hadith, إِنَّا خَيْرَ الْحَدِيثِ كِتَابُ اللَّهِ. The best speech is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So with that, let us begin with the recitation of the Quran. And the first will be Surah Al-Mulk by Sahil.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. تبارك الذي بيده الملك وهو على كل شيء قدير الذي خلق الموت والحياة ليبلوكم أيكم أحسن عملا وهو العزيز الغفور الذي خلق سبع سماوات طباقا ما ترى في خلق الرحمن من تفاوت فارجع البصر هل ترى من فطور ثم ارجع البصر كرتين ينقلب إليك البصر خاسيا وهو حسير ولقد زينا السماء الدنيا بمصابيها وجعلناها رجوما للشياطين وأعتدنا لهم عذاب السعير وللذين كفروا بربهم عذاب جهنم وبئس المصير إذا ألقوا فيها سمعوا لها شيئا وهي تفور تكاد تميز من الغيظ كلما ألقي فيها فوج سألهم حزنتها ألم يأتكم نذير قالوا بلى قد جاءنا نذير فكذبنا وقلنا ما نزل الله من شيء إن أنتم إلا في ضلال كبير وقالوا لو كنا نسمع أو نعقل ما كنا في أصحاب السعير فاعترفوا بذنبهم فسحقا لأصحاب السعير إن الذين يخشون ربهم بالغيب لهم مغفرة وأجر كبير جزاك الله.
It's always a pleasure listening to kids reciting the Quran. Since this is going to be a completely children's program, so there's not going to be any speeches from elders. So alhamdulillah, you have time to enjoy just the kids. Now we have Surah Al-Bayyinah from Hamza, and he is also one of the students of our HIPS program.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم لم يكن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين منفكين حتى تأتيهم البينة رسول من الله يتلو صحفا مطهرة فيها كتب قيمة وما تفرق الذين أوتوا الكتاب إلا من بعد ما جاءتهم البينة وما أمروا إلا ليعبدوا الله مخلصين له الدين حنفاء ويقيموا الصلاة ويؤتوا الزكاة وذلك دين القيمة إن الذين كفروا من أهل الكتاب والمشركين في نار جهنم خالدين فيها أولئك هم شر البرية إن الذين كفروا إن الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات أولئك هم خير البرية جزاؤهم عند ربهم جنات عدن تجري من تحتها الأنهار خالدين فيها أبدا رضي الله عنهم ورضوا عنه ذلك لمن خشي ربه.
Alhamdulillah, this kid is also known as Sheikh Sudais, and I really want you to listen to one of his qiraat. So,
you want to give Shahada or Surah Fatiha? We'll tell you better, Sheikh Sudais. Okay.
If you know who Sheikh Sudais is, he is the Imam of Masjid al-Haram in Saudi Arabia. And if you heard Surah Al-Ala, if you heard the recordings or you heard them, then you can match him. But if you haven't heard Sheikh Sudais, then it's time for you to listen to Sheikh Sudais. So inshallah, just 5 ayats of Surah Al-Ala, 5 or 6 ayats.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبح اسم ربك الأعلى الذي خلق فسوى والذي قدر فهدى والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى سنقرئك فلا تنسى إلا ما شاء الله إنه يعلم الجهر وما يخفى ونيسرك لليسرى فذكر إن نفعت الذكرى.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم اقرأ باسم ربك الذي خلق خلق الإنسان من خلق اقرأ وربك الأكرم الذي علم بالقلم علم إن الإنسان ما لم يعلم كلا إن الإنسان ليطغى أن رأى استعنى إن إلى ربك رجعى أرأيت الذي ينهى أبدا إذا صلى جزاك الله.
We have Dua Qunut by Nizam.
Allahumma inna nasta'inuka wa nastaghfiruka wa nu'minu bika wa natawakkalu alayka wa nusni alayka al-khair wa nashkuruka wa la nakfuruka wa nakhlu wa natruku may yafjuruka Allahumma iyyaka na'budu ونرجو رحمتك ونخشى عذابك إن عذابك بالكفار ذم الإخ.
We have now Surah Fatiha by Isa.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم الحمد لله رب العالمين. All praise to Allah, the God of the worlds. Ar-Rahman Ar-Rahim, the entire merciful, especially merciful. Malik Yawm Al-Din, the owner of the Day of Judgment. Iyaka Na'budu wa Iyaka Nasta'in, you who we worship and you who we ask for help. Ihdina As-Sirat Al-Mustaqim, show us the right path. Sirat al-lazina wal-amta alayhim ghayr al-maghdubi alayhim wal-dallin. Ameen. Show us the path which you have chosen for us, not the path who angered you or leads astray.
We have Surah Al-Kawthar by Sana.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنا آتيناك الكوثر فصل ربك وانحر إن شانئك هو الأبتر.
We have Surah At-Teen by Safiya Kawthar.
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والتين والزيتون وطور سينين وهذا البلد الأمين لقد خلقنا الإنسان في أحسن تقويم ثم رددناه أسفل سافلين إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات فلهم أجر غير ممنون فما يكذبك بعد بالدين أليس الله بأحكم الحاكمين
أحسن أحسن. One thing I can say about this little girl is she recites better than her father. We have the last surah for this section, Surah Abasa, the first 10 ayats by Farhan.
A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, abasa wa tawalla anja'ahu al-a'ma. وَمَا يُدْرِيكَ لَعَلَّهُ يَزَكَّى أَوْ يَذَّكَّرُ فَتَنْفَعَهُ الذِّكْرَى أَمَّا مَنْ اسْتَغْنَى فَأَنْتَ لَهُ تَصَدَّى وَمَا عَلَيْكَ أَلَّا يَزَكَّى وَأَمَّا مَنْ جَاءَكَ يَسْعَى فَهُوَ يَخْشَى فَأَنْتَ عَنْهُ تَلَهَى.
The first one is probably an addiction that we always have. We just can't remove ourselves. We try to connect to Allah, but it just doesn't happen. Instead, you connect to our TV, television sets. Here's a talk by Sara, Life with TV.
رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَالْعُقْدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُوا قَوْلِي يَا أَيُّهَا الْإِنْسَانُ مَا غَرَّكَ بِرَبِّكَ الْكَرِيمِ O man, what has deceived you about your gracious Lord? Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. My dear respected elders, friends, guests and relatives, I welcome you with the Islamic greetings. May peace, mercy and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. The topic of my talk is life with TV. Not everything that comes through TV is bad. However, the average child between 2 and 11 years old watches over 27 hours of poorly supervised television per week. Because the only thing kids can do more than watch television is sleep. And because most parents are unaware of the indecent liberties that television takes with our children, you must control this 19-inch shaitan. Halal, permissible and haram, forbidden. It is the job of parents to observe halal and haram on TV programs. One rule you can use while teaching your children rights and wrongs in television is the following. If it is haram to do, then it is haram to watch. Don't just allow watching TV. Allow your children to watch a particular program which you have approved. Not just watch TV. Homework first. Insist that homework and course be done before TV is turned on. No, this is not considered as child abuse. Only 1 in 10 parents require homework first before TV is turned on at this moment. Watch together. Watch TV with your children. It'll be lots of fun. You may share some topics. You might have some topics to talk about later. You may share some laughter as well. If you can't do this all the time, at least do this occasionally. Talk to your children about the programs. Talking to your children about the programs they watch or you watch together will give you an opportunity to debrief the rights and wrongs in television. Never use TV as a babysitter. No matter what, don't just train your little Muslim to be an avid TV watcher by letting TV calm him or her down when he or she is crying or when you want to attend on something else other than the baby. A smaller size is better than a larger size. A smaller size TV is better than a larger size TV. A larger size TV encourages worse watching habits. One TV is better than two. One TV placed in the living room will help you keep an eye on what is being watched. A TV in your child's bedroom is the worst thing. It is not that you don't trust your children. It is the TV which you don't trust. More family activities. TV takes away family time. Poorly managed television wastes opportunities for kids to learn how to relate to other people, including their parents and siblings. Children follow you. The bottom line principle of parenting is that children follow you. If you are a couch potato and fail to practice what you preach, don't expect any of your rules to have any value. Watch what you're watching if you want anyone to follow your rules.
We have good character by Saba.
Rabbish Rahli Swadri, Vayasirli Amri, Walul Ubdatam Mil Lisani Yafkahu Kaudi, Inna Kala Kulukin Azim. My respected elders, guests, and my dear friends, I welcome all of you with the Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace, mercy, and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. The topic of my talk is good character. Good character includes suppressing one's anger and being gentle and humble. Allah Most High has said, "Surely you're of tremendous nature, and those who forgive other people and suppress their anger, surely Allah loves those who do good." Bukhari and Muslim relate, Abdullah ibn Amr said, "The Messenger of Allah was never immoderate or obscene. He used to say, 'Among those who are beloved to me are those who have the finest character.'" The meaning of good character is the inclination of the soul towards gentle and praiseworthy acts. This may take place in one's personal actions or in actions which involve other people. In the former case, the slave of Allah was never had a welcoming and open heart for his commandments and prohibitions, and does what he is imposed on happily and easily, and abstains from the things forbidden him with full contentment and without the least dissatisfaction. When he deals with other people, he is tolerant. When claiming what is right, he does not ask for anything which is not. Good character may be something which a man is born with, or it may be acquired. However, it may be acquired by someone who has it more firmly rooted than his own. It is well known that a man of sensible opinion can become even more sensible by keeping the company of intelligent and sensible people. And that a learned and righteous man can learn even more by sitting with people of learning and righteousness. Therefore, it cannot be denied that a man of beautiful character may acquire even more beautiful character by being with people whose characters are superior to his own. And Allah gives success. Jazakallahu khair.
SubhanAllah. Jazakallahu khair. What happens on a very, very hot day? All of us require some shade. But just imagine when you and I are on standing on a day where the sun is brought close to us less than your arm's length. How much of shade do we need that day? Just imagine, subhanAllah. But there are seven who will get the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's throne. Who are they? Let us know from this talk by Ayman.
Rabbish Rahli Sadri Vayasirli Amri Wahalil Ukhdatam Mil Isani Yafkhahu Qawli. My respected elders, guests, and my dear friends, I welcome you with the Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Today, the topic of my talk is the seven under the shade of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There are seven whom Allah will shade on the day when there is no shade except Allah's shade. A man who is just a ruler, a yath who grew up worshipping Allah, two men who love each other for Allah's sake, a man who is called by a woman for beauty and position, a man whose heart is attached to the mosque. Now let us examine the seven categories. First,
a just ruler. The concept of justice in Islam is really very important for the ruler and the ruled one to follow. Second, Ayat who grew up worshipping Allah. According to the sentence, there's a hadith by Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that make benefit of five before five, life before death, health before your sickness, and wealth before your poverty. Third, a man was called by a woman for beauty and position, and he says no. This world is full of temptations which lead to burning of fire. Amongst them is that which comes first, woman. May a man has led his soul into destruction on account of the rule of a woman, which is why the Prophet warned his ummah specific about this. Sixth, a man who gives in charity and hides it, such that his left hand doesn't know what his right hand gives in charity. This describes the type of person who goes to treat lengths to protect himself from arriya. Arriya means to do deeds to order to earn the praise and recognize the people. This sin destroys all the benefits that lie in right ears. Seventh, a man who remembered Allah in private, so his eyes shed tears. Our noble Prophet, peace be upon him, informed us, if you knew what I knew, you would laugh little and weep much. Crying is not a sissy thing to do. The Prophet, who was the best of all the creations, would weep as would all of his companions' tears. And a genius experience of fears of Allah punishment are then removed of tears. Alhamdulillah, through these seven types of people mentioned in the hadith, we have been given clear importance of the way to attain Allah's pleasure and satisfaction. So dear brothers and sisters in Iman, devote yourself to being one amongst those seven. For indeed, fortunate will be those who are granted Allah's shade on the day when there will be no shade but His shade.
So inshallah, let us now know about the 12 months in Islam by the junior group, inshallah.
Please. Who can tell me how many months there are in 1 year?
12.
Well done, mashallah. Now the months tell us when we must fast and make hajj and celebrate Eid. Now who can tell me what those months are?
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. These are the months in Islam. Muharram, Safar, Rabi'un, Awwal, Rabi'u Thani. These are the months in Islam. جماد الأولى جماد الأخرى رجب بن شعبان رمضان من شوال ذو القعدة عن ذو الحجة في سنة من سلسان محرم صفر ربيع الأول ربيع الثاني في سنة من سلسان جماد الأولى جماد الأخرى رجب بن شعبان رمضان من شوال ذو القعدة عن ذو الحجة في سنة من سلسان.
Our calendar, the one that we follow, does it go by the sun or the moon? Well done.
Muharram, Safar, Rabi'un, Awwal, Rabi'un, Thani. These are the months in Islam. Jumad al-Ula, Jumad al-Ukhra, Rajab and Shaban. Ramadan in Shawwal. Dhul Qa'da and Dhul Hijja. These are the months in Islam.
A link with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is dua. Allah's Messenger says in a hadith reported by Imam al-Tirmidhi, Ad-dua for ibadah. Dua is ibadah. So let us now listen to six beautiful duas that you and I should do while we eat, drink, walk, wake up, going to the toilet, going to the wearing clothes, and then leaving our homes. So the first one will be dua before drinking milk, and that is by Neha.
Assalamu alaikum rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. I am going to recite
dua before drinking milk. That is, Allahumma barik lana fihi wa zidna minhu.
Next, before sleeping, dua before sleeping, and that is by Amina.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dua before sleeping is Allahumma bismika mutu ahya.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The dua after waking up is Alhamdulillahillazi ahyana ba'dama amatana wa ilayhin nushur.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The meaning of the dua is all praise for Allah who gave us life after having taken it from us and untold his resurrection.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Dua when entering the toilet. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubuthi wal-khaba'ith.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. The meaning of the dua is, O Allah, indeed I seek your protection from the male and female jinn.
Dua before dressing is Alhamdulillah allazi kasani haza warzaqni min ghairi hawlin minni wala quwwah. The meaning of the dua is, all praises due to Allah who has clothed me with these garments and given them to me without any help and effort from my side.
The dua before leaving home is Bismillahi tawakkaltu lillahi wala hawla wala quwwata illa billah.
The meaning of this dua is, in the name of Allah, I trust in Allah, there is no power and might except from Allah. Thank you.
Now we have a group recitation of a grand surah, a surah that the Prophet ﷺ loved and always recited, most of them recited on Yawm al-Jum'ah, the day of Friday. And that is Surah Al-A'la by the senior group.
Surah name Allah, Surah number 87. Surah meaning the most high. Total ayat 19. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Sabbih isma rabbikal a'la allazi khalaqa fasawwa wallazi qaddara fahada wallazi
to a nice machine, mercy like the rain.
Allah, 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 All
bearing fruit, showing us the greatness of Allah. Blossoming flowers, bearing fruit, showing us the greatness of Allah. Of Allah. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Can you feel the rain is falling down? Falling down. Falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Can you feel the rain is falling down? Falling down. Falling down. Mercy like the face that shines within us. Mercy like the prayers that Allah answers. Mercy like the face that shines within us. Mercy like the prayers that Allah answers. How it gives purpose to our lives, helping us strive for paradise. How it gives purpose to our lives, helping us strive for paradise. Paradise. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Can you feel the rain is falling down? Falling down. Falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Can you feel the rain is falling down? Falling down. Falling down. Mercy like the smile for one another. Mercy like the kindness for each other. Mercy like the smile for one another. Mercy like the kindness for each other. Oh, how it takes sadness from our hearts, spreading God's love throughout the world. Oh, how it takes sadness from our hearts, spreading God's love throughout the world. Spreading love. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Can you feel the rain is falling down? Falling down. Falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Can you feel the rain is falling down? Falling down. Mercy like the messenger of Allah. Mercy like the Quran from Allah. Mercy like the messenger of Allah. Mercy like the Quran from Allah. Truthful, generous, wise and kind, bringing Allah's words to mankind. Truthful, generous, wise and kind, bringing Allah's words to mankind. To mankind. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Can you feel the rain is falling down? Falling down. Falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Mercy like the rain is falling down. Can you feel the rain is falling down? Falling down.
Person in our life is the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And when Allah has made him a guide for us, he deserves some rights, and he has some rights. Let us know those rights due to Allah's Rasul by Akish.
Thank you.
Rabbi Shirley Swadri, Vayasili Amri Walul Uktatam Milisani Yafkau Kauli. Let me start by a Quranic verse, Surah Al Imran, Surah number 3, Ayah number 31. Kul in kuntum tuhibun Allah fatabbi auni. Say, O Muhammad to mankind, if you really love Allah, then follow me. Accept Islamic monotheism and follow the Quran and the Sunnah. Allah will love you and forgive all your sins. And Allah is all forgiving, the most merciful. Good evening, my respected elders, guests, and my dear friends. I welcome all of you with the Islamic greeting, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace, mercy, and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. The topic of my talk is going to be rights due to Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him. The rights due to Allah's Messenger, peace be upon him, rank highest amongst the rights of all creatures. No other creature is eligible for a higher right than that due to Allah's Messenger. Allah says in the Quran, Surah 48, ayah number 8 and 9, Verily we have sent you, O Muhammad, as a witness, as a bearer of glad tidings, and as a warner, in order that you, O mankind, may believe in Allah and His Messenger, and that you assist and honor Him. Hence, love dedicated to the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam must assume precedence over love to all people, even oneself, offspring, and parent. In this context, Allah's Messenger said, "None of you will come. None of you will taste real belief until I come closer to his heart than his child, parent, and all other people." When Muslims honor their Prophet, they in fact honor his Sunnah and his flawless law. The companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam honor him because he was very honorable and gentle hearted. Had he been severe and harsh hearted, they would have broken away from him. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has the right over us to believe whatever he said about the future and past, to abide his orders and to abstain from what he forbade. It is our duty to believe that the Prophet's guidance is the most perfect and his Sunnah is the most comprehensive. It and comes before any other law or system of whatever source. It is also our duty to defend his Sunnah as much as we can in accordance to the situation involved.
One of the greatest ayats in the Quran is of Surah Ar-Rahman, where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Kullu man alayhi afan, that every single thing will destroy. Yes, sooner or later everything will destroy. And this is a talk by Yusuf, sooner or later everything will perish.
رَبِّ اشْرَحْ لِي صَدْرِي وَيَسِّرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَاحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِّن لِّسَانِي يَفْقَهُوا قَوْلِي كُلُّ مَنْ عَلَيْهَا فَانٍ Everything on this earth will perish. Surah Ar-Rahman, verse number 26. My respected elders, guests, and my dear friends, I welcome all of you with the Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace, mercy and blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon all of you. Today, the topic of my talk is sooner or later everything is to perish. That is for all of us, for the oppressor and the oppressed, strong or the weak, rich or the poor. Death is no novelty. Nations before have gone and nations after will perish. Ibn Battuta reported that there's a graveyard in the north which has 1,000 kings buried in it, and in the entrance is a signboard which reads, "The kings ask the dirt about them and the great leaders. Now they all are bones. A cause for wonder is the forgetfulness of man and how he remains heedless of death. the menace of which hangs over him day and night. Man deludes himself by thinking he is immortal on this earth. O mankind, fear your Lord and be dutiful to him. Verily, the earthquake of the hour is a terrible thing. Chapter number 22, verse number 1. The day of reckoning is drawing closer, and man turns away in heedlessness. Chapter number 21, verse number 1. When Allah destroyed a nation and wiped out everyone, he said, "Can you even see any of them or even hear a whisper?" Chapter 19, verse number 98. All traces are gone.
The Quran has about 6,236 ayats. Ayat means a sign. And most of them, about 1,000 of them, or more than 1,500, speak about signs. Today, let us now know about some scientific facts in the Quran by Sufyan.
رَبِّ سَهْلِ صَدْرِي وَيَسَرْ لِي أَمْرِي وَأَحْلُلْ عُقْدَةً مِنْ لِسَانِي يَفْقَهُ قَوْلِي. My respected elders, guests, and my dear friends, I welcome all of you with the Islamic greeting. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace, mercy, and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. Today, the topic of my talk is scientific facts in the Holy Quran. لَقَدْ خَلَقَنَا الْإِنسَانَ فِي أَحْسَنِ تَقْوِيمٍ. Verily, we have created man in the best of forms. Science says, fingertips can be used for identification. Quran says, does man think we cannot assemble spots? Yes, we are able to put together the very tip of his fingers. Science says, atoms are found in pairs. Quran says, glory be to Allah who has created everything in pairs. Created in pairs all things that the earth produces as well as their own kind and other things which they have no knowledge. Science says, honey is healing for mankind. Quran says, comes from their bellies a drink of varying colors wherein is healing for mankind. Verily, in this is a sign for people who reflect. Science says, separation of salt and seawater. Quran says, verily, he is the one who has joined the two seas. This is palatable and sweet, and this is salty and bitter. And he made a barrier between two of them, and a partition that it is forbidden to be passed. Science says, milk as he holds a meal. Quran says, and verily for you in the cattle, there is an instructive sign. We give you to drink which is in their bellies between excretions and blood, palatable, pure milk palatable to the drinkers. Science says, oceans have darkness under their surfaces. Quran says, or is darkness in a deep, vast sea? There covers waves from above which are waves, from above which are clouds. Darkness on top of each other. If a man stretches out his hand, he can hardly see it. And whoever Allah does not make light, for him there is no light. Science says, iron and steel. Quran says, and we send down iron in which is severe strength and benefits for the mankind. Verily, in this is a sign for people who reflect. Science says, sun and moon. Quran says, it is not permitted to the sun catch up with the moon, nor the night outstrip the day. Each floats in an orbit. Science says, creation of living creatures are from water. Quran says, we made every living thing from water. Quran says, science says, mountains have roots inside the earth. Quran says, have we not made the earth as wide as an expanse and mountains as pegs? Jazakallah khairan.
Hassan, we now have the junior group performing a poem on Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.
Forest, he
Now we have a very beautiful nasheed by the boys, and this is something that always haunts us, the shaitan. Let's see what the kids do to the shaitan.
Oh shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down right into the ground.
Oh shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down, right out of this town.
For so many years you've been pestering me, whispering a secret in the night. Oh shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down right into the night. Oh shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down right into the night. On this blessed day, you pale and weak, hiding in the corner, filled with grief. Cause people come a marching, praising your love, casting you right out of their hearts. Oh, shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down right into the ground. Oh, shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down right into the ground. You pledge to Allah, your only desire, to take us all with you straight to the fire. But Allah has supreme power, he will devour your plans for believers till cometh the hour. Oh shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down right into the ground. Oh shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down right into the ground. You've been causing trouble since time began, a snake in the garden, and you tripped the first man. Oh shaitan, I'm gonna throw you down right.
Islam is a way of life from the junior group again, inshallah.
Do you know what Islam is? It's a way of life for all. It is taught in the Quran, from big and small. A way of life, a way of life, a way of life, a way of life. Islam is a way of life, a complete way. Do you know what Islam says? It says that life's the greatest test. It says that life's a borrowed space, return upon rest. A way of life, a way of life, a way of life, a way of life. Islam is a way of life, a complete way. Islam solves all of its problems, all the leaves, no stone unturned. Perfect with no flaws at all, are the laws of Allah. A way of life, a way of life, a way of life, a way of life. Islam is a way of life, a complete way. It's a complete way.
What's the first thing that we learn in Islam? First thing that we learn in Islam. Shahada is a part of five pillars. So let's learn about the five pillars of Islam by Zain.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. The five pillars of Islam are first Shahada, second Shahada. La ilaha illallah Muhammad Rasulullah. Second Salah, we pray 5 times in a day. Third Zakat, which help the poor. Psalm, we fast for Allah in the Ramzan day. Fourth Zakat, rich, help the poor, give money and clothes, etc. Fifth Hajj, a pilgrimage once in a lifetime. Jazakallah.
Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said in a very beautiful hadith, there are two things that we lose very quickly. We don't take advantage of, or rather, we don't appreciate. One is good health, and second is time. And when it comes to time, alhamdulillah, we have a lot of time. And those who are very, very busy and can't remove time, don't manage their time too well. And those who have time and remove it for Allah, are the ones whom Allah blesses. But in a day, if you can't remove 10 minutes, what's the point for Allah? What's the point for 10 minutes for Allah? Let's see what we can do in 10 minutes, a talk by Rayyan.
Rabbish Rally Sadri, Vyasili Amri, Vahlal Uptatam Milisani Yafkau Kauli. My respected elders, guests, and dear friends, I greet you with the Islamic greeting Assalamu Alaikum Warahmatullahi Wabarakatuh. May peace, mercy, and blessings from Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala be upon all of you. Today, my topic is what you can do in 10 minutes. The Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that the best actions are those which are continuous even if they are little. After I looked at my own state and the state of others who waste their time, I thought we could encourage our souls to obey Allah azawajal by compiling a list that Allah has taught us. Allah has also prepared a great reward for doing those actions. My goal in compiling the list is not only to point out the action, but it is also to remind ourselves to organize and plan our time by investing in something good. First of all, let us talk about time. Many people are heedless and wasteful about time. Only a few recognize the importance of time. Time is like wealth. We are careful about spending and managing our wealth, so we should be careful about spending and managing our time too. The difference is we cannot collect wealth, but we can collect time. Every minute which has passed will never come back, even if we spend all the wealth in the world to get it back. So dear brothers and sisters, let us make a sincere intention to preserve our time and not waste any minute of it. Imam al-Nawawi, may Allah have mercy on him, said that the best actions are those which are continuous even if they are little. Explains that in a hadith, Allah asked us to perform deeds regularly and continuously, and a small deed done regularly is better than a great one we do sometimes. It is because a small deed which we do regularly accumulates and multiplies, and a great deed we do sometimes, this exceeds great deeds which we do sometimes, but it is interrupted. So, dear Prophet, the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alaihi wasallam spoke the truth. My dear brothers and sisters, I will tell you about the utilizing 10 minutes of righteousness. Saying Subhanallah 100 times means that you say 36,500 times in a year. If we read the Quran for 10 minutes regularly, we can finish the Quran in 2 months. If we learn one verse every day, we can memorize the whole Quran in 8 years. The Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu asked the Prophet, who are the best people? He said, the best people, their life is long and are with good actions. He asked the Messenger again, who are the worst people? He said, their life is long and are with bad actions. This is an opportunity, my dear brothers and sisters. 10 minutes of being regular in performing righteous actions will be a step forward to managing one's time. And until our whole life becomes beneficial 10 minutes, that is in agreement with saying, Allah Azza wa Jal, I have not created the jinn or human unless to create me. Ibn al-Qayyim, may Allah have mercy on him, said that when a servant turns away from Allah and is busy with him, he loses days of his true life. He will see the result on that day, and he will say, oh, I wish I had sent some good to my life here. I will list some actions that can be done in 10 minutes. Teaching children, salawat on the Prophet, remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal, giving charity, taking account of oneself, visiting Islamic knowledge, visiting relatives for Allah's sake, and spreading Islamic knowledge.
Rabbishrahli sadri wa yassirli amri wahlul uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli. Kul wallahu ahad, Allahus samad. Allah is rich and you are the poor. This is the fact that none can escape, yet to go after the treasure of the world and renounce the Lord of truth. Know that the life of this world is but a play and passing delight and beautiful shows. Look at this world with your physical eyes. It will lure you to the side of slaughter. But look at it with your eyes of your heart. You will find it ugly and loathsome. Fear in Allah in your innermost being. and implement His commands. And whosoever has put trust in Allah, He will surely find a way for him to get out of all difficulties. Beg of His mercy, turn to Him with a sincere repentance. Turn, O you who believe, turn to Allah with your sincere repentance. Remove the evilness and darkness that have clouded your heart. O you sound of well but weak heart. Run to your Creator with a repentance in your tongue and tears in your eyes. Cry for your Creator before others cry for you. O heedless one, make haste. Jazakallah.
The last speech for the day will be Kibr, Pride by Farhan.
Rabbi Shali Sadri Vayakrili Amri Vahlul Ugdatum Millisani Yafkau Kali. My respected elders, guests, and my dear friends, I welcome all of you with Islamic greetings. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. May the peace, mercy, and blessings of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be on all of you. The topic of my talk is the disease of kibir, a characteristic that everyone has to be cautious of, especially those who are ill and who are doing da'wah, is arrogance and pride. That is the disease of kibir. These people will not accept any kind of criticism. They do not want anyone to correct them. Our Prophet Muhammad once said, no one who even has a mustard grain seed weight of kibir in his heart will not enter Jannah. Someone asked the Prophet Muhammad, if we like to wear nice clothing and shoes, will this be kibir? The Prophet Muhammad replied, Allah is beautiful and loves beauty. This is not kibir. Kibir is to reject the truth and look down upon people. You have to realize that even an alim can make mistakes. Even a child can correct a mistake. Al-Bukhari was just 11 or 12 years old when the first time he corrected the sheikh. Hence, we have to be careful not to have kibir, especially since we are the students of knowledge. So stay humble and shun kibir out of your life. Jazakallah.
Now we're going to finish this program with two skits. One is going to be the funny skit and the other one is going to be the serious one. And the theme of both the skits is going to be death. The first one is, what do we do when somebody dies in our family? And this is going to be based upon the funny skit. And inshallah, this is going to be performed by this senior group. Just about 2 minutes, inshallah, we should start.
Mamu jaan, mamu chale ke beta aayo. Ye mamu, kya toh ye? Bola, bola mamu, tab hota hai, tab jaana sab ek din Allah ka ne kya kar di. Salam Papa. Allah, Mamu chale gaye na. Mere pyare Mamu. Zara, bahar kya dhoop hai malum? Main sunscreen laga ke aayi, dekho sunscreen. Aari ho jate na? Naam bol nahi hai. Na bhi, aise nahi. Phone ki Mamu chale gaye kate. Hum na kya chodo? खाने आया वही तो चाड़े अंगे भी उतनी मजे की नहीं रहती भाई मुझे तो खुशूस है नाड़ी से भूख लग जाती हाँ चाय भी बड़ी मस्त मिलती है यार ले भाई जमा के पियो क्या माँ काया काना एक भूख बस Thank you. quiet, I believe. It hasn't come to the movie today. Yeah, bye. Hey, dude, what's up? Come on. How are you, huh? Come on, dude. Hey, check it out. My new iPhone. 55,000, dude. Hey, bro, let's take a selfie.
Among the words that I do say,
happens, no matter what happens, whatever you've done in your life will be there.
Come on, my brothers, let's pray.
We only have one life to live, brothers and sisters. Make sure we use it well. Before our last prayer. The first will be for third prize Quran recitation for the junior group, and for the boys we have two winners for that. The first one is Zaidan, the third prize Zaidan and Shahid. First Zaidan. Hamza and Farhan, third place. And for the girls, third place, senior group, we have Shahnaz. We conducted a final exam, and third place for the final exam, junior group, the boys, Safi and Zain. Third place, Safi and Zain. And for the girls, third place, it's Riha. The third place for the senior group, boys, we have Akish in the third place. And for the girls, third place, final exam, senior group, Aisha. Thank you. I call upon my father, Mr. Maqbool Hussain, if you can come up forward, please. We have the most obedient student, junior group, and that is Neha. The most obedient student, senior group, goes to Shahnaz. Both of them are girls. Junior group and senior group. You can never expect boys to be obedient, right? Next, second prize, Quran recitation. Junior group, we have the boys, Safi. And he's the son of our imam. In the girls, second place, Quran recitation goes to Sana. In the senior group, the Quran recitation, boys goes to Sahil, second place. And girls, there were two, second place, Zana and Sara. Now, in the final exam, second place, junior group, boys, goes to Isa. And girls, second place, final exam, junior group, goes to Amina. In the senior group, boys, second place, final exam, goes to Sufyan. The one who gave the talk on science, scientific facts. He also looks like a scientist, right? Girls, second place, final exam, goes to Saba. Jazakallah khair. Now, to give away the last segment, may I call upon a retired superintendent of police, Mr. M.M. Gokak, who is a very keen member of our team, inshallah, alhamdulillah. So in this segment, inshallah, we have the most promising student for the year, junior group, and that is Riha and Zain. This award is given to the most promising, alhamdulillah, who's got a lot of talent and they showed a lot in their class tests. Most promising student in the senior group, we have three students. One is Zana, most promising student in the senior group. Second is we have Farhan. And third, we have Rayhan. Now we have a very important award which goes to two kids who've been very, very regular. So the most regular kids. One goes to Sufyan for being the most regular in Sunday school. And second, both of them together goes to Yusuf. He was the angel in the skit, huh? I'm sure he's going to go back and question his father now. Next, the most enthusiastic kid of the entire Sunday school goes to Sara. Now we have the first group, first winners of all segments, inshallah. And the first one goes to the Quran recitation for the junior group. And in the boys goes to Isa. In the girls, it's Luke Jane. In the senior group, Quran recitation, alhamdulillah, a student of our gifts program, boys goes to Bilal. Senior group, girls, Quran recitation goes to Ayman. Final exam. First, who came first in the junior group? Boys goes to Shahid and Zaidan. In the girls group, junior group, we have Ilham who came first. The final exam, first in the senior group. I'll go with the girls first, girls group, who got 97 out of 100. SubhanAllah. Ayman. I should give the same test to my students, Sunday class. Inshallah. Now, the one who scored the highest among the boys and the girls, and who came first in the boys, Alhamdulillah, who also came first last year, is again Bilal from Hikmah, who got 98 out of 100. SubhanAllah. Tahmeer. Great performance, Alhamdulillah. Now, the youngest stars of Hikmah in Sunday school. The youngest stars of Hikmah in the junior group, we have Rehan. Then we have Yusuf. Then we have Safiya Kausar. Now this looks match face, no? And then we have Nadine. So now we come to the most prestigious honor and award, and that is the student of the year for the entire Sunday school for the year 2014 and 2015. In the junior group, we have Ilham. No expressions at all. In the senior group, Alhamdulillah, I was really shocked to know about this girl. She is only in second grade, that is second standard, and she comes first in the senior group. And she is Aisha. Student of the year.